Hello, everybody. My name is Dmitry Karpov, and I'm here with Pyle and Company. Welcome to the show.
From the Pyle Media Venture Studios in Noblesville, Indiana, it's the return of Pyle and Company with Jacob Pyle and his guest co-host for the week, Dmitry Karpov. And now, here he is, Jacob Pyle.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Don't pour your love out on me, baby. Then I think that maybe I'll just lay me down, cry for 100 years. Don't pour your love out on me, honey. Take my heart, my soul, my money, but don't leave me drowning in my tears. You say you're gonna leave, gonna take that big white bird, gonna fly right out of here without a single word. Don't you know you'll break my heart when I watch you close that door? Cause I know I won't see you anymore. Don't pour your love out on me, baby. If you do, then I think that maybe I'll just lay me down, cry for 100 years. Don't pour your love out on me, honey. Take my heart, my soul, my money, but don't leave me drowning in my tears. Haven't I been good to you? What about that brand new ring? Doesn't that mean love to you? Doesn't that mean anything? If I threw away my pride and I got down on my knees, would you make me beg you pretty please? Don't pour your love out on me, baby. If you do, then I think that maybe I'll just lay me down, cry for 100 years. Don't pour your love out on me, honey. Take my heart, my soul, my money, but don't leave me drowning in my tears. There's so much I wanna do. I've got love enough for two, but I'll never use you, girl, if I don't have you. Don't pour your love out on me, baby. If you do, then I think that maybe I'll just lay me down, cry for 100 years. Don't pour your love out on me, honey. Take my heart, my soul, my money, but don't leave me drowning in my tears. Don't pour your love out on me, baby. If you do, then I think that maybe I'll just lay me down, cry for 100 years. Don't pour your love out on me, honey. Take my heart, my soul, my money, but don't leave me drowning in my tears.
Thank you. Oh, you guys are too kind. Thank you very much. Welcome, everybody, to the return of Pyle and Company, or should I say, welcome to the return of Pyle and Company and my all-new Pyle Media Venture Studios here in Noblesville, Indiana. My name is Jacob Pyle. Glad to have you with us. Let me just say that I want to thank everybody who sent me their well wishes as I begin this new chapter of my life. There's so many things I learned about this small town in the past few weeks. While Noblesville is a small town, it has expanded so much to the point where there's plenty here for people to do, and I look forward to bringing Pyle and Company to these small studios of Noblesville. Eventually, later on down the road, I'm going to see about getting something bigger and better just to record these podcasts in. But this will do, and it's really nice. Also, in addition to that, in 2 weeks from today, April the 15th of 2023, we are going to be changing the format of Pyle and Company. Yes, you've heard me correctly. I've gotten a lot of responses from people saying, and I think our guest co-host for this week, Dmitry Karpov, was one of those people that said, why don't you just get a permanent co-host for Pyle and Company instead of doing a rotating co-host roster? Well, We are going to have two guests join us each week, as well as a permanent co-host. You will meet our brand new permanent co-host next week on our show. And no, I'm not going to tell you who the new co-host is as of yet. It's a surprise. So you'll just have to wait till next week and to find out who that co-host is going to be. But regardless, we got a good show for you. As I said, my guest co-host for this week is Dmitry Karpov. And we'll be back with more Pyle and Company after this. Welcome back to Pyle and Company. A couple of months back, when we were in our Sharpsville studios, we pre-recorded a lot of material that was to be shown on future episodes, but due to my move to Noblesville and things like that, I hadn't had any time set aside for the podcast till now. So what you're about to see was pre-recorded back in January, February of this year, and it was an interview we did with Dmitry Karpov. Dmitry was a fun guy to have on our show. We talked about a lot of things. He's an actor, and he's done a lot of... What's interesting is, I mean, he's played a lot of bad guys in movies, but he's actually a good guy underneath. So, here for the first time is my interview with Dmitry Karpov. Dmitry, welcome to our show.
Hey, guys. I'm really, really, really happy to be with you here today, and I'm excited. I'm excited to meet you, all of you.
Go ahead and tell us a little something about yourself.
Well, I was born in Russia, as you can probably see by my name, and being an actor in my heart, I moved to California, Los Angeles, about 20 years ago to pursue my dream, my career. I've done a few movies and TV shows, and right now we're actually just releasing a show called, a future film called A Cash Collector with Michael Madsen. Mike Madsen, you guys probably remember him from Reservoir Dogs and a lot of Quentin Tarantino's movies. It's a wonderful show, and it's going to be available on streaming this year. And, you know, being Russian here, meaning that I'm always a bad guy in every movie, just following the tradition. Luckily, we redeem African-American community. They're no longer bad. They're playing good guys, and... Arabs-American also is not super bad now, but Russian we're kind of still in play, and specifically what happened to Ukraine, so we all pray for Ukraine, and I hope it's going to end up in peace, but here we are. I was doing a movie and playing again a better Russian guy, badass, but I love it, it's very interesting work, and I'm happy to share this project with you, so follow on IMDb and Amazon Prime and other networks, Cash Collectors, guys.
All right. Now, what made you get you started into acting?
You know what? It's very, very, very interesting question. As far as I remember myself, I always wanted to be an actor. And my mom is like, you know, when I was born, it was Soviet Union. She's like, you cannot come to America. You know, America is not good. You know, they're going to be like, no one's going to like Russians. I was like, but I like Hollywood. I remember watching Rocky, I remember Schwarzenegger, Commandos, I remember watching Predators, and Jean-Claude Van Damme. I started doing martial arts, karate and judo, and for me it was just like, it was my hero. I had like a poster of Schwarzenegger on one wall, and in my room in another wall I had a Rambo, so that was just, it's my surrounding. I grew up in the sense where just Soviet Union collapsed, or about to collapse, in early 80s. And we just started getting this American movies in our, was actually streamed illegally. So somebody get a tape, and they would invite you to an apartment complex, you know. They put the tape, they paid you like $1, one ruble, like it's like $1. And you pay to watch a movie with like a horrible, horrible dubbing. Like one person dubs everyone, but it was just like, I remember the first time I watched an American movie full feature. It was a movie called The Predator with Arnold Schwarzenegger. I literally could not sleep at night. I was so excited because I've never seen that type of movies in my entire life. And as a kid, I would just, it kind of stuck in my memory. And as far as I remember myself, being a little kid watching American movies, I was like, I want to be an actor. And look, my parents told me you can't do it. My friends like, what are you doing? How are you going to get to United States? There was Soviet Union, an Iron Curtain. Can't go anywhere. You can't get a visa, nothing. But guess what? It's just a dream in my heart. You know, as long as you follow your heart and pursue and pursue and pursue your dream, it came true. It, like, I believe that dreams can actually, you know, eventually come true if you really truly believe in, do as much as you can to make it happen.
All right. And finally, what's your advice to young people who might be interested in getting their start in acting?
It's, today is actually a very, very interesting era. When we started in late 90s, early 2000, basic path was just to go to acting school, right? Get it as much as you can and go there and try. All right, that's what people did. Like, you just become a waiter, you become a Uber driver, whatever it is, go ahead and try. Stop going to castings, auditions and stuff like that. And if you're lucky, if people see you, if you get in the right place in the right time, then, you know, you can, it's going to happen to you. It's like 5%, 1% out of you know, millions of actors who try. And actually, SAG, American Screen Actors Guild, has over 200,000 actors, and only maybe 5% of them working actors, meaning they pay for their bills by doing acting. It was before the streaming platforms, before YouTube, before TikTok, before Facebook. Right now, it's a different story. And my advice is, make yourself. Okay, you have so much potential, not only act, but write, produce, direct, film. It's all acceptable. You don't need to have a special education to understand how to turn on the camera or to write a short clip. Everyone's doing it now on Instagram, on Facebook, on different types of platforms. They're all open. If you're talented, if you're creative, then you can come up with a very, very good idea, and people will love it and follow you. And then someone down the line will look at you and give you an offer that you cannot resist. And it's not only like you doing yourself, but look, network. Find people that also, as you are, interested in acting. Or someone may be interested in producing. Someone's maybe interested in directing. Found them. Communicate. Work with them. Creating a group. Creating a show, podcast, a YouTube channel. Funny video channel, serious video channel. I don't care. Just do it. Go ahead and actually create content. That is the key of success. If you're able to create content, there's a unlimited ability for you here in Hollywood or everywhere, anywhere in America and in the United States to actually sell your product and really being paid for what you like to do. That's my best advice.
All right. And again, for those of you who have not heard, Cash Collectors, is that the name of it?
That's correct. Like Cash Collectors.
Cash Collectors can be found on Amazon Prime, and is it already out, or is it?
It's going to be out this year. It's already finished. Pre-production finished. Yeah, we're gonna. Right. I think we're gonna have a premiere in February, and then it's going to be in streaming platforms.
All right, so look for Cash Collectors sometime later in the year on most streaming platforms. And Dmitry Karpov is going to be with us throughout our show this week. And yeah, when we come back, we'll look back through the Pyle and Company archives, plus more with Dmitry Karpov. So stick around, we'll be right back. I want to say this. We had a lot of people saying how much they loved and missed the skits we did when I was involved with the newscast for the youth ministry. So, once a month, we are going to replay one of those skits for all of you. I had the fun part of hosting this game show-themed skit entitled Consequences. It's sort of like Let's Make a Deal, except it deals with real-life scenarios, which you're going to see is mostly a reenactment. None of the stuff you'll hear in the skit is true. And it gives you the chance to learn about the consequences people face with all the time. So, here from 2013 is Consequences. Roll it.
And now, coming to you live from our studios in Sharpsville, Indiana, it's time to play the game of Consequences. It's the game that allows you to choose the outcome of different circumstances in your lives by choosing your own actions. Will these contestants make the right decision? We'll find out as we play the game of Consequences. And now, here's the star of Consequences. Why, it's Mr. Consequences himself, Jacob Pyle.
Thank you, Chris Henry. Hello, everybody. I'm Jacob Pyle, and welcome to Consequences. Here's how the game is played. I will be giving each contestant their circumstance and then giving them the actions from which they will choose. Understand and always keep in mind that you can always pause the game at any time and choose to consult the lifeline. Yes, this Bible is a lifeline which can help you determine which actions you should take. And if you make a mistake in your choices at any time, hey, you can ask for forgiveness and confess your sins, which will then guide you to change your actions, which may help you alter some or all aspects of your circumstances. If you get through all of life without ever making a mistake, you win. And if you can be completely perfect, you get to go to heaven. Do you understand how we play the game, guys? Okie dokie. Let's introduce now contestant number one, Trenton Byers. Come on up.
I'm ready. I don't need any. I just go by what feels good to me.
Okay, Trenton. You have a big mathematics test coming up. Your first choice is to do is this. Do you study or do you go out and have fun?
I want to have fun.
Okay, now you decide to have fun. So, when you go to take your test, you do not know some of the answers. Your next choice is as follows. Do you do the best you can or do you cheat and look at the student's paper next to you?
I need to do well on my test because it doesn't feel good to fail and look like a loser, so I choose to cheat.
You pass the test, and as you go through school, you continue to cheat, and you continue to pass. Now, you want to go to college, right? And so you have to write your SATs, but you fail because you have never really learned mathematics. Surprised you, didn't I? You have a few choices. You can get a part-time job so you can take evening courses to improve your test score so that you can try to maybe get into college. Or you can work as a cashier at the supermarket for the rest of your life and try to be content with that. Or you can live a miserable life on the streets.
But I really wanted to be an architect and design buildings.
I really hate to be the one telling you this, Trent, but in order to work as an architect, buddy, you have to be really good at mathematics.
Oh, come on!
Sorry. Okay, our final contestant for the evening, Dustin Clifton, please step forward.
I'm worried about it. I've confessed all my sins, so all my sins are forgiven.
Okay, Dustin. You have a difficult life. Your father left you when you were very little, and your mother is angry at life most of the time. She doesn't hit you, but she sometimes calls you names.
Pause. I need to consult the lifeline. Matthew 5:44. Love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you.
Okay.
I would tell my mom that things she says to me hurts me very much, but I forgive her and still love her. I'd also tell her that Jesus loves her and I would be praying for her every day.
Now this action touches your mom a little bit, but she still continues to call you names.
Pause. Matthew 11:29-30. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. I would definitely keep trusting and learning on Jesus. As well, I would stay involved in the church where I would also have a spiritual family to help me.
Your mom tells you that there is no food in the house until she gets her next paycheck. She tells you to steal food from the grocery store.
Pause. I'm just going to stay right here, if that's okay. Exodus 20:15. You shall not steal. I tell her that I will obey her unless it goes against what God says, and God says that stealing is wrong. That I then go to the church for help. They put together a food hamper for us.
Now one day, you get very angry and blow up at your mom, and you call your mom a name.
Pause. James 5:16. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The effective prayer of a righteous man can accomplish much. I apologized to my mom, and I continue to pray for her and show her love.
Your steadfast love and actions are a great witness to your mom. She eventually goes to church with you and becomes a believer.
Yes! Awesome! I'm so happy.
Let me see that. Colossians 3:25. It says, for he who does wrong with will receive the consequences of the wrong which he has done. Why wouldn't we want that, man? I would want to be an architect, but even more than that, I want to have this free gift of eternal life.
So, ladies and gentlemen, as you can plainly see, there are eternal and daily consequences to our actions and choices. Which actions will you choose? Who knows? You might be the one having to face the consequences!
When we come back, I'll have a song for you, so stick around.
Once again, your host and Pyle and Company, Jacob Pyle.
Kiss me each morning for a million years. Hold me each evening by your side. Tell me you love me for a million years. Then if it don't work out, then if it don't work out, then you can tell me goodbye. My coffee with a morning kiss, soften my dreams with your sighs. Tell me you love me for a million years. Then if it don't work out, then if it don't work out, then you can tell me goodbye. Then if it don't tell me goodbye. If you must go, I won't grieve. If you wait a lifetime before you leave. But if you must go, I won't tell you no, just so that we can say we tried. Tell me you love me for a million years. Then if it don't work out, then if it don't work out, then you can tell me goodbye.
Thank you.
We'll be back with more Pyle and Company after this.
Okay, my thanks to my co-host for this week, Dmitry Karpov, for stopping by. We had a lot of fun. Join us again next week, where my guest co-host will be Bill Shumway, as well as that surprise guest I told you about at the top of the show. It's going to be an exciting episode of Pyle and Company next week, and I hope to see you then. I'm Jacob Pyle. Thank you for watching, and until next time, make it a good week. I know I will. So long, everybody.
The Consequences skit announcer was voiced by Chris Henry. Contestant number one was played by Trenton Byers. Contestant number two was played by Dustin Clifton. Contestant number three was played by Brian Bookout. For Pyle and Company, I'm Butch McCain.